Another Jordan 4 in 2024 is on the way, following the Jordan 4 Bred Reimagined, the woman's exclusive metallic gold, and up next, it's another woman's exclusive featuring hints of yellow. We've seen quite a few yellow Jordan brand shoes this year already, like the Jordan 1 and Jordan 6 yellow ochre. This one, although it's not actually yellow ochre in terms of the shade of yellow, I think it's pretty close. Air Jordan 4 Vivid Sulfur. This shoe is dropping on April 6th for $210. It is a woman's exclusive, just like the metallic gold Jordan 4s that just dropped recently. And back in 1989, when the original Jordan 4s first came out for a price of $110. That might not sound like a lot, but it's actually more expensive than $210 when you convert it to 2024 money. First impressions of the shoe, it is extremely difficult to make an ugly Jordan 4. I'm pretty convinced, even I, as someone with no artistic or like creative talent, if you gave me a canvas like the Jordan 4, I could make a pretty clean shoe, especially with white as a base. And this shoe falls into that category. It's very clean, it's very nice. It's not something that gets me super excited. Like, this doesn't trigger like a reaction out of me, but it's a clean white shoe on a Jordan 4 silhouette with that yellow that's not too bright. It's kind of a little bit more muted than like super bright yellow. The yellow is kind of like a banana, but yeah, overall, it's a pretty clean shoe. And the official color of the yellow, it is Vivid Sulfur. So compare it to like the Jordan 4 Lightning. Not sure if you can see a stark difference in the video, but this is Tour Yellow, Vivid Sulfur. It's actually pretty similar, kind of similar shade, at least in person. This one's slightly brighter, I think. But yeah, it's pretty close. This is more like a mustard yellow. Now, out of the Jordan 4s that have like hints of yellow that I have in my rotation, like this one, as well as the Lightning and Thunder that I have behind me, I think my favorite out of them is probably still the Lightning, followed closely by the Thunder, because I do love black shoes. This is not bad at all, but I think just the Lightning and Thunder are just slightly better. And the materials on the shoe, it's pretty standard, just leather upper sole and the leather. It's okay, it's pretty average, nothing too special. It's not like a super soft type of leather. Pretty typical in what you would expect for a lot of Jordan brand shoes. And of course, the most distinct thing about the Jordan 4, it is that netting to give this shoe more ventilation, as well as the wings. Very, very iconic. Just one of the best looking shoes, like, to this day. And you can also see the lacing system is slightly unique on the Jordan 4. Depending on the fit, you can use any of the holes, I guess, or eyelets up here, so it kind of changes the fit a little bit. Personally, I usually just stick it through the middle. And then moving up to the tongue, you see that Jordan flight tag with the Jumpman in the middle. Jordan 4 is the first shoe where Jordan brand introduced the flight concept. So you see it on the tongue, you'll also see it on the box, which I'll get to later. And then speaking of the tongue, you'll see the Air Jordan tag upside down. And the reason why they made the tag upside down is because back in the day, people would wear their tongues like this, flipped out. So they anticipated it, made it upside down. So when you flip it out, it's the right side up. I've yet to actually see anyone wear their shoe like that, but maybe someone will bring it back. Maybe that'll be the next trend. Now, earlier this year, when the Bred Reimagined released, there were some rumors, or at least what I thought were rumors, of the Jordan 4 going forward to have this shape more similar to the Jordan 4 SB Pine Greens, as well as the Bred Reimagined, where it's much more comfortable, more sleeker, more similar to the original Jordan 4s that came out in 1989. This shoe, this Jordan 4 in particular, the shape seems to have like reverse back. I don't know, anyone prefers this type of shape over the more sleeker and slimmed down version of the Jordan 4. And I'll get to more on sizing and comfort later, but yeah, feels like a Jordan 4 in terms of comfort, not in a good way. And moving on to the booty of the shoe, you'll see the Jumpman on the back. It's not Nike Air branding. Non-OG colorways usually won't have the Nike Air branding unless you're like Armand Manier or like a very special collaborator with Jordan brand. Maybe they'll make an exception, but for all intents and purposes, if you're not an OG colorway, you get the Jumpman on the back. And the black on the shoe, the official color is actually anthracite, so it's not like deep black. It's got this kind of matte or like charcoal look to it. I think that actually looks pretty cool. I do like anthracite as a color. Just gives it a more vintage type of look without it being like too in your face. And then speaking of the heel tab, this is more similar as well to a general Jordan 4 that we're used to. The Jordan 4 Pine Greens came with very bouncy and flexible heel tabs. This one, more the regular Jordan 4. And the Jordan 4s comes with a polyurethane midsole with a Nike Air unit that's visible, of course, on the back, as well as one on the forefoot. And my least favorite thing about this shoe, kind of nitpicking, but that sail midsole towards the back, or I think the official color is coconut. Don't know why they had to make that sale. I do not know. Yeah, it's actually pretty yellow in person. Just don't really like how that looks. And of course, you'll see it on the outsole as well. Very, very nice outsole. One of the best with the Jumpman on the cutout. Usually for OG colorways, it'll be Nike, but non-OG colorway, it is Jumpman on the cutout. And the sale extends here, and yeah, just would have looked so much cleaner with white. It ruined it. And the insole of the shoe, it is a dream cell insole. I kind of wish they came with like a polyurethane foam insole to make up for the lack of comfort for Jordan 4s, but nope, this is what you're gonna get. And the box of the shoe, a pretty regular Jordan brand box with the flight logo. As I mentioned before, Jordan 4s was the first shoe to introduce the flight concept. And this metallic kind of gold color on the Jumpman actually looks pretty cool. Paper, just Jumpman paper, nothing much to it. Now in terms of sizing and comfort, I'm a size 9.5, true to size. I do have wide feet for Jordan 4s. I go up half a size, and it's one of the shoes that's just not perfect for wide footers. When I go up half a size, it's slightly a bit too long in the toe box area. There's a bit too much wiggle room for my liking, but if I didn't, my toe box would be absolutely strangled. It'd just be in a chokehold. The Jordan 4 is notorious for being very tight around that area, can really hurt people's pinky toe, even for non-wide footers. So for me, I have to go up half a size, otherwise, yeah, I'd never be able to wear a Jordan 4. Now, even considering that, even going up half a size, Jordan 4s are just so stiff, especially ones that don't have that shape like the Jordan 4 SB Pine Green or the Bred Reimagined. This one is like the other Jordan 4s that's came out in recent memory. Even when you break it in, it's not comfortable. I've worn the Jordan 4 Midnight Navy for a long time now. Wore it quite often just because I like how it looks, but destroys my feet every single time. It is not a comfortable shoe. Polyurethane midsole, as well as two Nike Air units on the heel, as well as the forefoot. That's the same type of tooling as the Jordan 3s. And technically it is lighter than a Jordan 3, but because of how uncomfortable it is, it just feels heavier, feels clunkier, feels bulkier. If it was a very comfortable Jordan brand shoe, it would literally be perfect. Because look at this silhouette. Just gorgeous. And that brings the total sole score of the Jordan 4 Vivid Sulfur to 25 out of 40. Pretty low score compared to other general releases. Now in terms of colorway, this is not a bad colorway. Again, it's very hard to make an ugly and bad looking Jordan 4. But in terms of like excitement and like, I don't know, just intangible feeling that a color of a shoe can make you feel. Doesn't really make me feel that, but it's still a good looking shoe. In terms of the materials, pretty average and general leather on the shoe. Honestly, nothing too special, kind of what you would expect from Jordan brand nowadays. So yeah, very general, very average, not too much to it. And in terms of the comfort, like I said before, one of the most, probably the most uncomfortable Jordan brand shoe from 1 to 14. I can't think of any other Jordan brand shoe that's more uncomfortable than this. This is up there with like a Nike Air Force 1, which is like, just straight up wearing bricks on your feet. Doesn't have that comfort like the Jordan 4 SB Pine Greens that everyone loves. I don't know why they don't just switch that shape and just make everyone happy, but for $210, you don't deserve their best. And in terms of the versatility, the Jordan 4 is a super wearable shoe. It is probably the most popular Jordan brand shoe right now. And in terms of the wearability, the colorway, because this yellow is kind of duller or muted, more muted than like probably the Jordan 4 Lightnings, it's a very wearable shoe. The yellow is not too bright, not too bold or too loud or too weird. And with the anthracite, I think it's a very, very versatile shoe. As I mentioned throughout the video, it's very, very hard to make an ugly Jordan 4, especially with this type of color blocking, a black midsole with the color on this part and hints of that same color all over the shoe. It's just very hard to mess up. You can actually swap out the color over here with pretty much any color on the color wheel and make it look nice on this shoe. But I do wish Jordan brand does not milk the Jordan 4 this year for all it's worth. I really wish they don't oversaturate the market, and I hope they don't go down the same route as the Jordan 1 and probably the Jordan 3 lately, when they make so many colorways that are very similar. So when you see a new colorway, you're like, I already have a very similar shoe, so why get excited over a new one? I really hope they avoid that trap, but I have my doubts. So that's it. Thanks for watching. Sole Inclined. Let me know what you think of the Air Jordan 4 Vivid Sulfur. Like, subscribe, comment, all the good stuff. And remember, tomorrow may never come, so wear your shoes.